بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Today I will be talking about aqidah in action, the basics of our Islamic faith through examples and stories. Today I will talk about tawheed, which means in simple terms confirming the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have you ever asked yourself why is tawheed so important? Tawheed means confirming the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why every book of Islam talks about it? Why shirk, which means the opposite of tawheed, which means associating partners and worshipping others in addition to worshipping Allah, is so bad? It is the only sin that Allah will never forgive. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah does not forgive. If someone dies on shirk, He's not going to forgive them, and He may forgive any other sin. In simple terms, Tawheed is like your operating system. It's like the Windows on your PC or the iOS on your iPhone. Once the Tawheed is corrupted, once your operating system is messed up, it doesn't matter even if you have the fanciest screen or the coolest apps on your phone, it's not gonna work. It's gone. All the deeds won't add any value in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Tawheed is so important, and to make that concept simple to us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us examples. He gives us a story in Surah Az-Zumar. The story talks about a fight that doesn't happen in a cage or in a battlefield. This fight happens inside the hearts of every human being. Allah says in Surah Az-Zumar, ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا رَجُلًا فِيهِ شُرَكَاءُ مُتَشَاكِسُونَ وَرَجُلًا سَلَمًا لِرَجُلٍ هَلْ يَسْتَوِيَانِ مَثَلًا. Allah is giving the example of two men. One man is enslaved to different masters. It's like an employee who's reporting to different bosses. And those masters or bosses, they are fighting, but they cannot fight in person, so they are fighting over his attention. They are fighting over his obedience. So one will tell them, go do the website, and the other will tell him, no, go work on this project. So they are fighting, and they're giving him conflicting orders, and the guy cannot take it. He's like in between, pleasing this person, pleasing the other person. Is he the same as the one who is solely owned by one master? And of course, some people might say this is talking about people in the age of slavery. But now we're living in a free world and nobody is enslaved to any idols. Well, guess what? Nowadays, slavery is more subtle. The slaves of nowadays, human beings, may be enslaved to different desires, different temptations, different addictions. They might be enslaved to brand names, to celebrities, to role models, to certain lifestyles. The same person might be a believer in the day and they do something else in the night, and they are following a certain lifestyle. The same person might have an identity at work that's different from the identity at the school, that's different from the real identity at home. Subhanallah. So people nowadays are enslaved to different things, and this is torture for them. This is torture in the dunya before the akhirah, because they don't know where to go. They cannot please everyone. Is this person the same as the one who's enslaved to one God, to one master, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then Allah says, Alhamdulillah, bal aktharuhum la ya'lamun. All praise and thanks be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the clarity of our deen, on the simplicity of our belief. And many people don't know about this. Many people don't know about Tawheed. This is why it's my job and your job to share the simple message of Tawheed, which has a great relief for people. Someone might tell you, I don't worship any master. I am not a slave to anyone. This person, unfortunately, he or she will be enslaved to their ego, to their desires. At the end of the day, you will be enslaved to somebody, to someone, or to different entities. And it's better to say, La ilaha illallah, and to enslave yourself purely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will benefit me and you, and will remind us of enslaving ourselves truly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakumullahu khayran. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.